6:45 in the morning. I got about 3 hours of sleep, but now I am going downstairs to the theater because what we are going to do is go to see Stingrays. We're going super early. In Grand Cayman, everyone leaves really early. Well, here we are. We're getting off the ship onto a tender. It's going to be our group. We're going to take a little tender over to Grand Cayman and go snorkel some stingrays.
Let's do it.
I'm here with Forbidden Games, Glenn Drover here, Sean Brown behind him, and we have a true pirate today, don't we?
Pirates, yar.
Pirates. We are going to go snorkeling some stingrays. Are you excited about this?
Oh, this is going to be insane. I'm so looking forward to this.
It's going to be so insane. It's going to be incredible. Awesome, in fact. So here we are in Stingray City. As you can see, behind me are the stingrays. And they're showing us a bunch of stuff. It is really cool. I mean, look at that. Look at that giant stingray behind me. Is that one of the most amazing things you've ever seen? Forbidden Games did an amazing job taking us out for this. And this is going to be a good day.
Well, there you go. Here is Tom's kids.
One, two, three, go. Kiss it. Now you're gonna kiss her for good luck, okay? Hold the kiss, look at it. Perfect. Turn your back.
Okay, Paula, how cool is this?
Get low. Smile. Now put your thumbs up, both hands. This is for your Facebook, right?
How cool is this, Paula? How cool.
It's so weird.
Come around, guys.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Here comes Crystal in here.
We're gonna bring it over, put it over your hands.
Okay, Crystal, you like it?
I like it.
It's so here we go.
Go, Jason.
I'm about to grab some of these stingrays. Amazing. Yeah. Amazing. Look at this stingray.
Smile, Jason.
Is this awesome or
Jason,
what?
Jason, stay some.
Okay, you got picture time. I'm gonna kiss it.
Kiss it, Jason.
Here is Tom. Tom is eating the stingray.
We're gonna get one more so Tom can eat the stingray.
Are you gonna eat the stingray, Tom?
Tom, look at the camera over there.
Nice.
There you go, Thomas.
There you go, Tom. Bite the wing, Tom.
I'm a hungry man.
He's got it.
I found Glenn here. Has this been amazing or what?
Oh, this is amazing. The water's perfect. Sunshine. Oh,
I know.
Stingrays are so cool.
Well, Forbidden Games did all this. Glenn's amazing. I mean, without their sponsorship, this wouldn't have happened. I think all the people who won the contest are super happy right now. It's just an amazing day and amazing
It was a great
time.
Day.
Well, we've set sail again. It's a gorgeous day, a gorgeous ocean, and I'm ready to go downstairs, see what's going on, dinner, gaming, and it's gonna be a good night. Well, you all saw the tropical blue shirt, but look at this cutie here. That is a little cute onesie, the baby blue onesie for the littlest cruiser, 13 months old, right? Uh-huh. Look how cute. Isn't that the cutest thing ever? I love this. We're so excited. We even make shirts for the littlest of little ones here on Dice Terror Cruise.
Thanks, Jason.
Yep. Well, look who I found. Where were you this morning? You were supposed to come on our stingray excursion, weren't you?
We were. We got locked out of our room for the second time in 6 hours. And so we missed the excursion because we couldn't get in our room because I forgot my sea pass in there. So, yeah, it wasn't great. It wasn't a good morning, let's just put it that way. But y'all had a good time, that's all that matters.
We did, but we have you tonight, so
yes,
we're gonna have fun, we're gonna play games. The game show yesterday was amazing.
It was fun, right?
Yeah,
it's real silly, go watch it.
I still don't know what that means backwards.
I think that was Power Grid.
So I'm up here at the Windjammer tonight. This is my favorite couple on the whole cruise because they're playing, look at that, it's an 18X game. My favorite game of all time, 18X is my number one game. You guys are 18X fans, I'm like so happy
we're
right now.
Big fans, yeah.
Big fans. Which ones do you guys play?
1808, definitely my favorite. We play 1830, 1860, 62, not yet, almost. 61. Yeah, several.
Plus a few online. Yeah. 56,
70.
C2C.
Oh, I love it. And that's super hardcore. OE, for those who don't know, is like a 12-hour game. It's like the heaviest of the heavy 18Xs. You guys are completely awesome.
Thank you.
I would love to do an 18X with you here. I don't know if I have the time, but hopefully we can get something in that's 18X or 18X similar. It'll be really cool.
Cool,
we'd
love that.
Okay, I didn't think this would happen, but it's actually being played. The giant ice pool here in the Windjammer. Look at this. Are you guys enjoying this?
It's fantastic.
It's good.
Best game of the year?
Second best.
Biggest game of the year. How do your hands feel?
Yeah, that hurt. I'm the one that yelped in pain.
I said the same thing. I flicked that thing and it hurts.
Oh, it's going to have bruised hands.
These are solid. But give it a flick. I want to see someone flick this thing. Get it over the board. Do a cool flippy. Sort of nice. I can get it in the air, and it hurts. It hurts a lot.
Look who I found. I found Kenny. Kenny is the man. He put together this whole library. That was amazing. The fact that we got this library on the ship, you did all this work. Like, you really, without you, this wouldn't have gone on.
Well, thanks. And it wasn't just me. It was everybody in the office. It really was.
It was. Except for Tom. Tom's the only one who didn't show up.
No, actually, Tom was a big part of it. In fact, he's the one who actually organized all this and created the system. Basically, how he wants the whole library to look like. So
I know.
But a lot of the grunt work, that's me and the guys.
It's worth it. We're going to see this library again at Dice Tower East, aren't we?
Yes.
Dice Tower West first. We're going to see it everywhere.
We're going to see it everywhere. Yeah. And it'll get better and better.
I know. And as we found out, we got to get stronger wheels because wheels break when they get lifted with a crane.
Well, made it back to the room. It was another good night. Didn't play a game. So I still have only two games I played all convention, didn't play a game today, but took care of a lot of people's problems, which for me is more important. I just want to make sure everyone else is happy and having a good time. And we did. And right now, getting ready for bed, but tomorrow I got a big day. We're going to Cozumel. I've got this thing called salsa and margaritas. Might be making a little stuff and also doing a little stuff. So it'll be cool. I'll show you that. But hope you guys enjoyed everything here. Grand Cayman was amazing. And looking forward to two more days on the ship before we get off in the third day. But for now, this was day three. And hope you're enjoying the blogs here from Dice Tower Cruise 2020. Getting ready for a good day. I've got salsa and margaritas, as you can see here, getting ready to go. But I'm gonna go play some gaming first. Today we're in Cozumel. It should be an amazing day. It should be an amazing time. I think all of you guys are gonna love this island and what you see on it. We got gaming, we got lots of stuff. I'm ready for day four here on Dice Tower Cruise 2020. I might be wearing the old shirt from the first year, but this is year four, and we're only getting bigger and better. 812 people, which is a lot more than when we started, which was 427. So we've almost doubled. I'm hoping in another 3 years we can double again, get to 1600 plus, and then get to the whole ship. It's coming soon, I promise you.
Well, here we are in the gorgeous Hotel Cozumel and Resort, and I can't wait to take a dip in this pool later. But for now, we're ready for our salsa making class. There is a chef here. So there's our chef. It's going to be a really good day. We're going to learn a lot. Very excited about this.
Well, you're not a real chef unless you have an apron and, of course, the chef hat. Very excited for this. It's going to be an amazing day.
Look at what we have here. We have a mortar and pestle some margaritas, a lot of nice ingredients here that I see that we're going to chop up to make our salsas. This is going to be a fun time. We've got Eric here with us. We've got Crystal here with us. And swinging around the other side, we've got Mr. Bonacor here with us. We're ready to make some salsa.
Salsa, salsa, margarita. Cabinets, please remove that white chepa and switch that one for the blue chepa.
The table captain, he's getting his blue chef hat.
Oh, very handsome.
We have chosen wisely.
Feet a little bit apart.
And here comes the dancing.
Big smile on your face. Big smile on your face. Now you need to try like the number 8, infinity sign, sideways. We call this the Latin hips. Let's start moving your hips like the number 8. All right.
You're making dashes, yeah?
So here we are. We've got our salsa. I've got chips. Crystal, you have your chips?
Got my chips.
Are we going to try our salsa? See how it tastes?
We're going to try our salsa for the first time.
Now your waiters, they are passing around.
A lot of it, right? We're going to
go. Here we go. Ready?
Yep.
Right. Cheers to salsa.
Cheers.
I'm going to try mine.
Here we go. Here's my salsa. Mmm. That is phenomenal. It's hot, but it's really good.
Yeah, no, it's really, really good.
So here we go. Green salsa, salsa verde. I've mushed this all together. We are ready to try salsa verde now. So I'm scooping out our green salsa. Look at that. It looks so good.
So here we are. Salsa verde. Let's taste it.
That's good.
How amazing was that food?
The food was lovely, because we made it.
I know, I didn't think I would be full from some salsa, but I am full from salsa.
It is very full, yes. There was a lot of guacamole, a lot of salsa, a lot to consume, plus ice cream, because we made dessert salsa.
I know, are we ready to now salsa?
Now comes salsa.
I found Steven. How amazing was that class?
Absolutely amazing. Not only did we learn how to make salsa, make margaritas, we ate and drank it all.
I'm Rod, by the way.
It was a great class.
Are we ready to now dance?
And now we're going to dance salsa music.
I know. This is an amazing excursion, amazing day.
The entire Daiso crew, seriously, you guys got to go. If you're just listening to this and you're not on the cruise, or in the future you get time, go on the Dice Tower Cruise. It's an amazing experience. You'll hang out, we'll have a great time together.
It is amazing.
And you get to see me kiss Jason.
Wow, I feel special now. Okay, here we are. We are about to salsa. I'm probably gonna make a fool of myself, but I'm ready for this. To salsa and dance. Look at this, we've got everyone behind us. We are getting ready to salsa and dance. It's gonna be amazing. Here we go. We are dancing. We are having a good time. This is as good as it gets. Made it back from the excursion. It was incredible. Gonna relax now, go down, do some games, have dinner, play more games. Tonight is the day for me of just gaming. I've got nothing else planned the rest of the day. I just wanna actually get to play some games. I've only done 2 so far, so hopefully I'll get through at least 5 or 6 or so the rest of the night. And maybe I'll see Greece, but I've seen it every year for 3 years, so this year we might skip Greece. It's still the word, but tonight I feel like gaming is the word.
So I was walking down the hall and look what I found. This is really cute. The Helm family put up a Dice Tower Cruise
magnet sticker thing. I have to find out where they made them, and maybe we'll get more people to do these next year. We'll see how it goes.
Well, here we are entering Chop's Grill. We have a nice staff dinner tonight, so I'm going to go in and see how everyone in the staff is doing. Well, we are having a nice staff dinner here. As you can see, all the gang is here. It's super nice. And oh, all the gang from Miami is here. Let me rephrase. So we're ready for a nice dinner here at Chop.
So just finished dinner, and we're having a little meeting of the minds. Tim runs Dice Tower West, which is coming up next month. And Sharon over here runs Dice Tower East, which is coming up in the summer. So if you're looking for any of our other events, Dice Tower West, Dice Tower East, Dice Tower West is end of February this year.
February
obviously,
26th to March 1st. Yep.
Yes, obviously the tickets. We already stopped selling tickets this year, but we're hoping that you all come to it. And if not next year, when do you think it's next year?
First weekend in March.
First weekend in March. So first weekend in March for next year for Dice Tower West. Dice Tower East, of course, as you know, we moved to Florida Hotel this year. We made it a little smaller than we've done in the past. And Sharon's here, and we're going to be doing that over 4th of July week like we always do.
July 1st through the 5th.
So hopefully you guys will come to some of our other events. Obviously, the cruise next year, as you've probably heard multiple times, is going to be on February 13th to 18th next year. So if you haven't seen the post yet, February 13th to 18th, 2021, is a cruise, same ship, Independence. We're going to Labadee, Haiti, and Jamaica next year again, like we did 2 years ago. So hopefully we'll see a lot of you there as well.
And we are playing my favorite game. Well, you heard this in my top 10 video. We are now playing one of my favorite games.
It just doesn't.
And I'm calling this already Game of the Year 2020, The Crew, one of my favorite trick-taking games. In fact, it's my favorite trick-taking game of all time. And if I could have put it on my list this year, I would have, but we're calling it 2020, so The Crew, I don't know what my hand is like yet. We'll sort it eventually, but I absolutely love this game, and I think this is phenomenal. So I'm going to go play The Crew, and hopefully you all get it soon. I know it comes out in the U.S., I think, in April, so I expect a lot of people to play this game when it does come out.
So we are going up the elevator. I just want to show you what the promenade looks like, such a gorgeous area, until we get up here into the upper decks. Deck 11, where the pool is. I just love the way the ship is laid out. It's such a gorgeous ship.
Well, I'm wrapping up for the night, and hope you enjoyed today. Cozumel was a lot of fun. Tomorrow we have a full day. Above Board is doing a screening. We have gaming. We have a show at night, which is going to be an amazing show with some magic from Brian Drake. And then we leave. But it's been a great cruise so far. Hope you're enjoying the vlogs, and I'll be back tomorrow for day 5, the last day of the cruise.
Day 5. I've got the Dice Tower Cruise 2020 shirt. We really took pride in making these cool, it's called Tropical Blue is the color here. So we took pride in making this awesome color for the shirts, which I really like. I'm ready for a good day. I'm gonna go downstairs. Above Board is doing something right now in the theater. They're gonna screen their show.
So I'm here with Travis, and you're here at our Dice Tower Cruise, and you're showing your Above Board episode 1.
That's right. This is the first time outside of test audiences that an actual crowd will get to see the pilot episode of Above Board.
Really looking forward to it. I mean, I've seen just a few little skits of it, and I think they are hysterical. So I can't wait to see what everyone thinks about the whole show.
Me too, I'm excited.
Well, I am walking up the stairs to Izumi. I'm about to do Hibachi launch, which is going to be just absolutely incredible. Here we go. Let's see the chefs put on a show for me here for a nice Hibachi lunch at Izumi.
Start to play the egg. Let's start for Roland. 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 Rolling on the river, let my good job in the city. Walking for a man every night and day. Yeah, smash it. Hey, all right, now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, higher, 7, 8, 9, and higher. Whoa, 1, 2, and higher. Oh,
well, Izumi was excellent. A great meal. Now I'm gonna go down to the game room, maybe get in one last game before we have to start packing up the library, so let's go down there and see what's going on.
No convention is complete unless you play point salad at least once. Here I am, gonna play point salad. Absolutely love this game, and it's probably my last game of the convention, but maybe I'll do something later.
After all, it was my number two game of the year, or number three. No, it was my number three game of the year last year. Wingspan was number one, City of the Big Shoulders number two. My third best game of the year. Have to play it at least once at the convention, so here we go.
So look at this tableau I have. Lots of scoring. I was the cabbage, tomato, pepper person, and I have a lot of stuff. I don't know my scores yet, but I absolutely love this game. We are putting our shells back together here. Let's see. Bungee cord. So we bungee cord everything in, which is really nice, so nothing flies away. We're looking for more of these bungee cords right now, but as you can see, we keep the library in a good place to not bounce around. And it is coming together. Our players wanted signs. This library looks like it's in good shape at this point, and hopefully we'll be out of here in the next hour and go eat dinner, which will be really nice. So here we are, look at this. We're with our logo on stars tonight. We've got the starry background. Ryan, is this like what a magician loves, the starry background?
Yeah, we're partial to the starry backgrounds of sorts. Are we? I don't know. Maybe some shiplap. Make it look all fancy and stuff, you know what I'm saying? But this looks great.
Yes. We have a huge crowd here tonight. This is the final show and people are packing the rafters left, right, center. It's pretty exciting. Look at this crowd. Tom is excited at this point. The crowd is excited. We're hoping we can fill the whole ice rink. We're pretty close at this point. I think by the time the crowd fully files in, we will have filled this whole ice rink tonight. This is impressive. This place holds almost 700 people, and we are going to fill it with our group tonight.
In the lounge like we were last year, as fun as that was, we were sitting on top of each other for each time. So there's a little bit more space for us. If you're here by accident, I'm Tom Vassell, and this is the closing night of the Dice Tower Cruise number four. So you should be crying a little inside. I didn't say it for ending. All right, we're going to get things started with a bang. I'm going to turn the show over for a bit here to Brian Drake to show us a bit of devilry. Or magic or something.
Ooh, that hurt my hand. That's a sturdy stand right there. One ball left, one bag left. Ball number two, bag number two. Give Kaylin a humongous round of applause. You can have a seat right there. Awesome job. Real quick. Yeah, one more thing I want to show you real quick. Okay, I know what you think. You're thinking, wait a minute. Brian, show us the knife. First thing, everything we do is mentalism, suggestion, it's illusions. Did you feel an actual palpable fear there? How many of you felt that? You were like, right? Exactly. But do you know what you never saw during that routine? A knife! Do you know why? Because it doesn't have to be a knife. I don't know her. She could be a crazy person, right? I just let her run. Some rando kid up here with a Dice Tower badge on. That doesn't mean anything, right? There doesn't have to be a knife to make it exciting. But something you wouldn't forget that you would never try at home. Jason, as if there really was one.
Game show, and the Murph brothers just went crazy because the question is fill in the blank. Blank Brothers and Murph Brothers was number four. They just went crazy running around the arena. Wow. And this wasn't on ice. This was on parquet.
Number six, Step Brothers. Number five, Mario Brothers. Number four, yes, the Murph Brothers.
If you were a volunteer at all in our library, helping check games in and out or doing other things, if you'd stand up, these people put a lot of work in here while you all have fun. And all of them get it. And the only reason we're here at some point is because of Kenny. Yeah, Kenny fixed pretty much every problem we had. So we appreciate that. Also, we have the directors of two of our other conventions here. We have Sharon in the back, Retro Baseball East. And I got you, Tim, are you here? Tim? Oh, when you see Tim, director of Dice Tower West.
Yeah, Tim!
Go, Tim! All righty. And of course, we want to thank Brian Drake and Carla for coming in and doing the magic trick. Woo! Okay, so once again, thank you to all of you. We really appreciate you coming. We know it's not an easy thing to do. We know that there was a lot of changes and things that went around, but we hope you enjoyed it. We increased numbers, but we also increased games. There was more games for people this year than there was last year. All right, that same game library will be at Dice Tower East and Dice Tower West, so go check those out. Also, Dice Tower Retreat, which we'll announce soon. And finally, the person who never sleeps and the person who puts all this together and tricks the cruise line, I'm sorry, I meant, the crew helps the cruise line tremendously, Jason Levine.
Okay, we did it.
It's over. That was a great show.
Is it done?
It was a great show. It was a great cruise.
Did we do it?
It was. I'm so tired. It was good. It was good.
I loved it. It was amazing. Bigger and better next year. We're so excited. We love you all. We really do.
I don't like that guy.
Who?
Oh, sorry. Oh, he's there. I'm sorry. What I meant is I like Eric.
Well, that's it. Another Dice Tower cruise done. 809 people, and it was incredible. We want to grow. We want to get to 1,000 next year. That's my goal. I'd love to see 1,000 people, which making it to four figures of people is going to be something else. Obviously, it takes everyone, you know. We already have sold a ton of rooms because we sold them here. We have a ton more we're ready to sell, and, you know, we want you all to come. So if you really like this, you know, I'd love to see you here next year. I'd love you to be part of the Dice Tower Cruise family. And we'd love to see you at the next one. 1 year, well, 1 year and 2 weeks from now, February 13th to 18th of 2021, we're going to do cruise number five. I can't believe it's been 5 years, but I'm right now tired, but I feel like everything was worth it. And I'm just so glad that everyone had a good time, that it was still what I consider the most amazing experience of any convention I go to each year. And it's thanks to the people who came here that made it, you know, our attendees make this special. And I'm very happy to have such great, loyal people. And hopefully those of you watching who have never been, you'll experience for the first time like 400 people did this year, and you'll see what it's about. And hopefully we'll get some of you out here in the future, because I want to show everyone how amazing this experience is. For now, though, this has been the end of Dice Tower Cruise 2020, and I'm about to get to bed and get ready to get back to Miami, and or Fort Lauderdale, I guess, officially is where we get in, but back to the reality of Florida and work. But it's been a wonderful experience, and I really do appreciate, truly, and love everyone that came here. They are my family. And for those of you watching, and once again, this is Jason Levine, the Gaming Machine, saying adios from the independence of the seas.